All right, so you're ready to get a GoPiGo. I'm going to be putting links in the description for basically all of the parts that you're going to need, as well as run through the initial setup process and stuff for you guys. So there's basically two major options here. You can either get like the base kit and then piece together the rest of the stuff that you need for your GoPiGo, or you can buy everything all together. Now, you'll save yourself about $50 if you piece it together, and then basically anything, if you already have, say, a Raspberry Pi or some of the other parts, you'll save yourself even more money. So, to me, it's better to get the base kit and then piece it together. But you can do what you want. The simplest option is, of course, to just buy the whole kit. But $50 is a little bit extra, if you ask me. That's a missile launcher right there. So anyway, I'll put links in the description for all the parts that we're going to be talking about here. They are Amazon affiliate links, so if you use them, you're supporting me and the channel. So thanks a lot for anybody who does actually use them. So first of all, the GoPiGo is made by Dexter Industries. And we can come to their website, click on Robots here, and then click the GoPiGo. So scrolling down, you'll see they offer a base kit and a starter kit and also a classroom kit, but we're not worried about the classroom kit. So the starter kit is $200 versus the base kit is $90. So you can get this, and it comes with a Raspberry Pi Model B Plus, the base kit, the servo package, and a distance sensor. So there's that. And whoops, I hit my back button. So you can get that, or you can get the base kit, piece it together, and save yourself a little bit more money. So anyways, continuing along here, step one would be the GoPiGo base kit. So you can get this here or through DexterIndustries.com. Again, if you want to support me and the channel, you can get it here. It's the same price, won't really change anything. It's actually even sold by Dexter Industries. So anyways, there's that. So you'll need the base kit. After that, you're going to need a Raspberry Pi. Now, you can either get the Model B or the Model B Plus. I believe you could get away with the Raspberry Pi 2, but you might have to add some code in, so I'm not positive how easy that would be for some of you. So if you want to stay safe, I would either get the B or the B Plus. Next up, you need a microSD card. Now, their image is a 4 gigabyte-ish image, but as you may or may not know, 4 gigabytes does not mean 4 gigabytes. It means about 3.6 or so. So if you want to be safe, I would get at least 8 gigabytes. 8 gigabyte SD card is $4. So might as well go with the 8 gigabyte SD card. I formatted one of my 4 gigabytes and I did not have enough space for their little custom image. So, you just keep that in mind. So I would get at least an 8. I usually get 16s though, and 16 is $2 more. So there's that. So you need SD card. And then finally, the other must have is the Edimax Wi-Fi adapter. So these are the main things that you'll need: the base kit, a Raspberry Pi, SD card for the Raspberry Pi, and an Edimax Wi-Fi adapter. One thing to note, if you get the B Plus or a later Raspberry Pi, you'll need to have an SD card that's actually like, it's an SD adapter for a micro SD card, okay? So keep that in mind, because the B Plus and later only take micro SD cards. It saves a lot of space, and also on the older models, the SD card really stuck out, and it was just really easy to break it. So it's a good idea to just go ahead and get the micro SD so you can be compatible with all the Pis. Moving right along, that was the Edimax Wi-Fi adapter. You'll need that. Then you have a distance sensor. Now you can get this distance sensor from two places. This is the basic distance sensor, and as you'll see, there's no cords here. So if you don't have any jumper cables or jumper wires, what you're gonna wanna do probably is splurge for the distance sensor that Dexter Industries sells. It's $19.99, so it's considerably more than the basic distance sensor. It does the exact same thing, but it has like the little plug here, and it comes with the cord that you need that has, you know, the ground, the trigger, the sensor, and the power. And so it's just really easy. But if you have some jumper cables around, I would just go with this one. It's way cheaper. But choose whichever one you want. They don't sell this one on Amazon, so you'll have to get it through Dexter Industries. Next up, Raspberry Pi camera module. This is so your robot can see. So for example, here we have me doing my lovely tutorial right now with my coffee that's on E at the moment. So I might pass out at any moment. Anyway, so you got this. This is so you can stream and see what your Pi is doing and all of that. So that's really useful to have. Also, in the later tutorials, we're going to be working with OpenCV. So this is just so you can see what your robot sees, but with OpenCV, that'll all be kind of behind the scenes. You won't really have to worry about that. But the camera module is really cool to have. It is a mere like $23 free shipping. So cheap, and it's really cool to have. So I highly recommend the camera module if you don't already have one anyways. Moving right along, the servo package. This is so, basically you have it here. You can also see it on my GoPiGo here on the screen. This is so you can connect your distance sensor and your camera to the servo, and then you can kind of, you can swivel the camera around and kind of look around with your camera and your distance sensor. This is probably the second to least necessary addition to your GoPiGo. But I think it's really cool, and for $13, I mean, might as well. So next we have the missile launcher. This is the least necessary, but it's also the coolest thing that you can add to it, if you ask me. So do what you want. We're going to be covering using, we will cover using the servo package here, and we will also cover using the missile launcher. You can actually have your robot automatically fire missiles at things. So that's really cool. So I highly recommend it, but it is $45, which is kind of high. But it does shoot these things for like 20 feet, so that's pretty cool. Actually, I think it says 25 feet. That's the promise. So anyway, I think it's cool, but probably the least necessary thing if you're needing to save some money. Next up, we have the tutorials, basically. So that's all the stuff that you need. We will have tutorials covering how to use all of this stuff. Calculating distances, using the camera, especially OpenCV. We'll be doing some more advanced tutorials with this camera module. The servo, like I said, it's not super necessary. You can always just turn your robot. You can make the robot itself rotate if you need to look around. So just, you can keep that in mind if you want. This thing's pretty cool. We're gonna try to have it automatically shoot targets. So it'll be kind of cool to have it, but again, you won't necessarily need it to follow along. Once you have your GoPiGo and all your parts, the next step is to put it together. So Dexter Industries, if you go here to Robots, GoPiGo, looking for GoPiGo instructions, yep, we are getting started. You'll click on that, and these are all you need to assemble the GoPiGo. You can click on that, and there's instructions. You can either get step-by-step instructions in kind of like written form for the GoPiGo servo package and the camera, but they also have video instructions for all of this stuff. So it's extremely simple. I really applaud Dexter Industries for how simple they made this GoPiGo. I realize it's a lot of little parts that we're kind of throwing at you, but as far as robotics go, this is really simple to put all this stuff together. So that's really cool. Now, after that, once you have it together, you want to connect to the GoPiGo. There's a lot of options, and there's, you know, depending on your operating system, how you're going to do this. My personal preference is to connect via SSH. Now, that's going to entail usually plugging in an Ethernet cable like a Cat5 to your Go or your Raspberry Pi, scanning for IP addresses, connecting that way. And so you can either do that to first figure out what your IP address is, because you can have your Wi-Fi adapter, but until you know what the IP address is, and then also until you actually connect to your Wi-Fi network on your Raspberry Pi, you're not going to be able to connect remotely. But anyway, section 4 here, connect to the GoPiGo, really simple. I recommend use option number 3 or option number 2, but 3 is where you're eventually going to have to get. Like, there's no point of having a robot if you always have to have an Ethernet cord attached to it. So definitely I would go with 3. I also learned something new. On Windows, you can get Bonjour, which is like a printer application, and you can automatically scan and find your Pi and connect to it via Bonjour, which I thought, like, that's really cool. I've never heard of anybody doing that. So, you know, for the first time that you connect to it, that makes a lot of sense. If you've never had to go through the process, maybe you won't respect that as much, but that's pretty cool. So anyways, you'll connect it. You got to get the IP at least initially somehow. Another easy way is just to connect a monitor to it, connect your Ethernet or your Cat5 cable, boot up your Raspberry Pi, and usually when you finally get to the login screen, just a bit above where you're going to log in, it'll literally say what your IP address is. So then you can connect via SSH, which is here. So like my Pi's IP address local is 192.168.0.109. So then from PuTTY, we log in that way. So then there's that. Also, if you haven't got to that point too, you're going to need to also install like your operating system to your Raspberry Pi. If you get the kit, it'll come with a 4 GB SD card with it already on there. But if you buy your own SD card, you're going to have to format it and install and mount the image. Now that sounds really complex, but it's not. And actually, you can, they have tutorials on Dexter Industries. Again, you can also find a really easy tutorial on Raspberry Pi's website. But this one's good enough too. You've got modify your own image and let's see, I'm looking for, yeah, right here. Option, if you come to option number 2 here, download and use ours. If you want to download, modify, blah, 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 we have step-by-step instructions here for mounting the image. So you come here and again, they've got it by SD or by operating system. Say if you're on PC, you download their image. Cool. You extract it. Cool. Then you use Win32 disk imager. Yep. And you mount the image. Really easy tutorials, just follow it. It's step by step, and that's exactly how you're supposed to do it, so easy enough. Now that you've got your operating system at that point, you're ready to rumble and actually start programming. So again, I realize that's kind of a lot of stuff to throw at you in one video, but once you get it all together, you'll find that from here, it's just smooth sailing. You just have to program the GoPiGo now. But luckily for you, there's like a base kind of framework or API, whatever you want to call it, built alongside the GoPiGo board. So like getting your, let's say you want to make your GoPiGo go forward. That is as simple as FWD, open, close parentheses, enter, boom, your GoPiGo is going forward, right? And so getting it to move is extremely simple. If you followed along our more advanced robotics series here, then you probably remember wiring it up was kind of a pain. And then actually controlling the H bridge to get your motors, because your motors go both forward and backwards, right? So getting the H bridge configured and set up, and then, you know, which IO pins do you need to trigger and send signals to? I mean, it was kind of confusing. So this would be like a little bit more of an advanced kind of robotics series. But as far as robotics logic is concerned, using the GoPiGo is incredibly simple and definitely worth your while. It's really nice and it's great for especially beginners and stuff like that. But then you can actually start getting advanced with it pretty quick. So I really like it so far. I'm a big fan of the GoPiGo at this point. So anyway, that's what you guys have to look forward to. What we're going to do in the next tutorial is get our GoPiGo to be controlled remotely by us using our keyboard. So we'll start off with that. We'll talk about autonomy in the subsequent video using the distance sensor and all that. And then after that, we'll be diving into the, and then we'll also actually, we'll cover how to use the missile launcher too by your keyboard, which is pretty cool. And then after that, we'll talk about using the camera module, OpenCV, and all that to automatically detect stuff and all that. So OpenCV is really cool because you start getting into like image recognition and stuff. And so that's a really exciting thing. And then getting your GoPiGo or whatever robot you're working with to automatically detect things and do things, that's really, really cool. So anyways, that's what you guys have to look forward to. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, whatever, getting your GoPiGo set up to the point where at least you can log into your GoPiGo like this, please feel free to leave them below. I'm using PuTTY on Windows. And then also for the GUI file system, I use WinSCP. I highly recommend WinSCP. Otherwise, if you can get to this point, then you're ready to continue on to the next tutorial. So stay tuned for that.